In this video, we are going to learn how to perform an on-demand backup of your PI data archive. Recall from the previous video that a backup is a copy of anything that makes your PI data archive unique. This includes both configuration files, as well as your archives, which hold your historical data. In general, you should have an automatically executed backup in the form of a scheduled task as part of your day-to-day backup plan. However, we understand there may be times outside of your regularly scheduled backups that you want to take a backup of your PI data archive. Some examples of when it's a good idea to take an on-demand backup include when you are going to migrate your PI data archive to a new machine, when you're about to make a big configuration change, or when you want to save a backup of your PI data archive to a location other than that of your regularly scheduled backups. So now let's take a look at how to perform an on-demand backup through the backup plugin in PI System Management Tools. While on my PI Data Archive machine, I'm going to open up PI System Management Tools by going to Start, All Programs, PI System, PI System Management Tools. Once PI System Management Tools is open, I want to make sure I'm connected to the correct PI Data Archive. Then I'm going to navigate to Operation, Backups. In this plugin, you can see a history of all backups that have been performed for your PI data archive. Additionally, this is the location where we can perform an on-demand backup. In order to perform an on-demand backup, I'm going to go to the top and select the Backup Now icon. The Backup Now item opens a window where you can see all files that you can include in a backup of your PI data archive. Note that the files are sorted by the PI Data Archive subsystem that they're associated with. Additionally, you can see a list of all of your archive files. Here, you can also see various pieces of information about the files, such as the size, the date it was last backup, or the date it was last modified. By default, all files are selected. However, if I do not want to include all pieces of configuration information or all of my archives in my on-demand backup, then I can deselect the corresponding subsystem or particular archive file that I would like to exclude. For instance, if I only want to include my primary archive in my backup, I can deselect all other archives. I can tell that this is my primary archive because it has an end time of current and it's named Archive 0. Once you've decided which files you would like to include in your on-demand backup, you need to specify a location for your backup. Again, this should be a different directory than that of your regularly scheduled backups. So in my case, I have a G drive specific to my PI backups, and here I'm going to place it in the folder for my on-demand backup. After you set the location of your backup, you can select the backup icon. You can then use the status bar at the bottom of the page to inform you on the progress of your currently running PI Data Archive on-demand backup. Once the backup is complete, it will also appear in your backup history panel. One thing to note is that all backups performed within this plugin are considered to be type copy. This means that it does not update the last backup attribute for each file. To confirm this, we can navigate to our Operation Archives tab within PI System Management Tools. Here, if I look at the primary archive that we included in the PI Data Archive backup that we just performed, I can see that it does not have a time for last backup set. Again, this is because all backups performed through the SMT plugin are considered to be type copy. It is only with full or incremental backups that the last modified time will be updated. We will learn how to perform both full or baseline backups in the next video, as well as how to set up our automated backups. Overall, we learned how to take an on-demand backup of our PI Data Archive through the backup plugin to PI System Management Tools. If I navigate to the directory that I specified for my on-demand backup, which in my case was G, on-demand, I can see not only that it backed up all of my configuration files for my PI Data Archive, but it also backed up the primary archive that I specified, as well as its associated annotation file. Please feel free to continue watching to learn how to set up automated backups of your PI Data Archive.